ونعوذ به من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد سبحانك اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته All praises and thanks are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. We thank Him and we praise Him and we seek refuge in Him from shaitan and from the evil of our own souls. And we bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship except Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without any partner. We bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Allah's messenger and he's a servant of Allah. We ask Allah and pray Allah to send salutations and peace. His blessings and salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his family and the companions. And we pray may Allah have mercy and be satisfied with the Sahaba and those who come after the Sahaba. And may Allah make us among them till the day of Qiyamah. May Allah bless all the people who will follow this way. Alhamdulillah, it is another opportunity for us to spend time in the masjid. We just use that time to remind ourselves, the one who's talking and you who's listening, we are all human beings, we are Muslims, and we all need to be reminded. If a person is sitting down and they reminded the Muslim or his fellow brothers and sisters, it doesn't mean that that person is ma'soom. That person is better. He's not, he knows already or he is already better. No. It is that the message that we give. And we pray, may Allah make us give the message the way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, gave the message. And may Allah forgive us our shortcomings. It is from the blessings of Allah for Allah also. Is the blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you to give you the time for Allah Himself. I will repeat. It is one of the blessings of Allah is that Allah will give time to spend for Allah. Because it is Allah who is controlling all our affairs. If Allah guide you and me and we are in the masjid after praying Maghrib, we still waiting until Isha, it is from the blessings of Allah. We should thank Him for that. And we will never thank Him the way He deserves to be thanked. Because we weren't like that. مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانُ وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا. Even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah told him that what he had, the revelation of Quran and everything, he wasn't like that. It means he wasn't having the book, the revelation. But it is Allah who put that light on him. So if Allah guide your heart towards the masjid, it's for you to recognize it. Nothing on the earth is better than that, brothers and sisters. There's nothing on the earth that is better than what? Allah guiding you to the masjid. So may Allah make us benefit from it. And we pray not Allah, you know, may Allah not leave us by our own till the day of Qiyamah. Alhamdulillah, we will continue with the reading of the book of Imam An-Nawawi rahimatullah rahmatullahi alayh, the 40 hadith. And we already reached the hadith number 24, we're still in it. And alhamdulillah, inshallah, the time we have, we will be able, inshallah, to complete it, inshallah. Because we have like 20 minutes, inshallah, which is good. The time is really fast now. The way the time is changing is so scary. Even the kuffar, they are saying 2022 did not see it coming. Did not see it pass. So as Muslim, we should realize that this is the sign of, you know, when the time is close. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when the qiyamah, the end of life, the end of this world is close, you will see everything become so short. A day will become like an hour. And you will see a week look like it's just 3 days. And a month just look like less than a week. Look at how the last time we prayed Juma, we are here. You remember the moment they said 2020, 22? But we already almost in the middle of what? You know, the first month of January of 2023. That's how it will be until it will, that death will just come, everybody, you know, all of us, one by one, and that's it. Our affairs with dunya is already finished. So we have to face the barzakh until we get to the day of qiyamah. So may Allah make our affairs so easy for us. And may Allah give us, you know, good health borders. Because it's so scary the way life is now. May Allah save us. So inshallah, we continue with the hadith number 24. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will repeat the hadith inshaAllah in English. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam related from his Lord, he said, "Oh my servant, I have restrained myself from oppression, wrongdoing, injustice. I make it haram for myself, upon myself. And I have made it prohibited amongst you. So do not oppress one another. Oh my servant, all of you lack guidance. It means all of you are misled, all of you are misguided, except whom I guide. So seek guidance from me or of me, and I shall guide you. Oh my servants, you are all hungry, you are all in need of food, except whom I feed. So seek food from me, and I will feed you, or I shall feed you. Oh my servant, you are all naked, except whom I clothe. Seek clothing of me, and I shall clothe you. Oh my servant, you sin. It means you make mistake. You err in the night and day, and I forgive all sins. So seek forgiveness of me, or from me, and I shall forgive you. Oh my servants, you are all capable of bringing harm to me, such that you may harm me. And you are incapable also of benefiting me such that you may provide me benefit. Oh my servant, where the first of you and the last of you, the man of you and the jinn of you, to be as the heart of the most pious one amongst you, that will not increase anything of my kingdom. Oh my servant, where the first of you and the last of you, the man of you and the jinn of you, to be where all of you to be, okay, as the heart of the worst amongst you, it means the most wicked, okay, heart amongst you, all right, that will not reduce anything from my kingdom. Oh my servant, where the first of you and the last of you, the man and jinn of you, stand, if you come to stand, of you to stand on a plane, and you all supplicate, you all invoke, you all ask Allah, okay? You all supplicate to me, and I grant everyone, okay, what he has asked, that will never reduce anything from what I have, except what the needle, okay, reduce from what? From the sea, well dipped in it. Alright? Oh my servant, it is but your actions. All what is matter is what? Your actions, brothers. Brothers, we should always focus on that, Allah. We are wasting our time, something that is so useless. It is all about your actions. This world is about your actions, brothers. I keep record of them for you. To me, it is recorded. Allah knows that what you're doing, but He made the angels recording everything you're doing. For for your own self. Okay? I keep record of them, of your action for you, and then I will recompense you with it as is due. You know, anyone who has whatever you act upon or your action, you will be recompensed according to your actions. Whoever finds good should give thanks and praise to Allah. The moment a person day of Qiyamah, this is what happened in the day of Qiyamah. Because the people of Jannah, when they make it to Jannah, we all know, وَسِيَقَ الَّذِينَ تَقَوْا رَبَّهِ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرَ حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوا until the end, he said, وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي صَلَقَنَا وَعَدَ. They say, Alhamdulillah. Even in Jannah, they say, Alhamdulillah, الَّذِي حَدَانَا لِهَذَا. What is for you to find yourself a Muslim is not, don't take credit from me, Allah. Can you imagine? The uncle of the one who brought this deen did not say La ilaha illallah for us. And today he is punished. He is getting punished for us. The one who took care of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Can you imagine that? When we all read Abu Lahab, Abu Lahab, Tabatheda, Abu Lahab, it is one of the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at the distance between you and that man. And that was the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that man is the one, until he was alive, Tabatheda was revealed. For like 7 years, Tabatheda descended and he was in Kufa. He not even changed. Until he died. The blood of the family, for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This man, because of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam birth, he even what? Relieved his servant. He freed her. So honestly, there is something we don't appreciate. It's for you to find yourself, Allah guide a little bit your heart to Islam. Well, I try to complete the rest. And you don't know, you don't worship Allah like the way you just have worshiped Allah since. Try to know about Allah, brothers. You're not gonna stay like that since years. The same way you are worshiping Allah until now. Try to know your Lord, brothers. A Muslim shouldn't sit down like that, please. Know your Lord, know your deen. If you don't learn it, wallahi, it will be a question about you. You're not gonna get any excuse. Fariida, it is mandatory for you to know your deen. We know certain things, aspect of the deen, you need to ask the scholars of the deen. But the basics, brothers, the basics for you and your family, the basics. You see a brother who was Muslim, he has children. Who will come one day and ask you about how? Of course, when they ask, Alhamdulillah, at least they still alive and they repent, they ask him. I remember I was giving classes. No, it's the children. I was even explaining the teenagers back home. But back home, when I was in the middle school, and there was a man over there who can be my father, I was explaining the young man how to take ghusl. He was praying, I think he was hearing what I'm saying, because I told them, you cannot pray if you are in general. I was explaining so on and so on. That man, after all, when I finished, he came to me and was like, what are you talking about? He was asking me, what is it? He doesn't know. I was like, Papa, what are you? When you have it close to your wife, you have to take ghusl. It's mandatory. Your prayer is not valid. Say, no, you know. He didn't know. We are busy with useless stuff, brothers. And this is years ago, brothers. I was like, I was 13 or something like that. And subhanAllah, I'm not even reached the age of puberty. Right? But I was explaining to those who are older than me, the teenagers, who were our teachers, I was thinking. So you can realize that we are so focused on useless stuff, but the basics people don't know. So if father who doesn't know, how will he teach the children, the teenagers he has in his own house? So what is our action is so important. We have to really realize it and increase our deed. I always say, if you used to pray your witr, prayer account, it's good, alhamdulillah. Okay, if you used to pray it right away in the masjid, it's good, it's not a problem. If you don't used to pray it, try to start praying. Pray and you move.
If you used to pray it while you in the masjid, try your best at least before you do it before you sleep. If you start doing that, try to do it the last third of the night. And if you used to eat, try to add another 5th, like 2 rakat. It's going to be 5 rakat. If you have 5 rakat and you realize that, because you will enjoy it, you will enjoy praying. You understand? You will enjoy what? Praying. Allah. If you really focus, inshallah, you will enjoy it. Allah will put, sweetness in it. If you don't pray, you don't feel anything. You don't feel yourself. You start 5 and you add another 2, 7. One day you're going to fail. And until you reach how the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi used to make 11 rakat. Brothers, it's not only Ramadan we pray 11 rakat night. You have, do it after Ramadan. Keep it like that. It's not mandatory, brothers. I'm not saying that this is mandatory. But I'm saying, as soon as, because when we get old, okay, we are getting closer to Allah. So the provision should increase. You understand? Your provision should increase, not reduce. Until when you reach the age where it's hard for you, because there will be a time, if you are still alive, for you to do even sujood, you cannot make it. For you to make rukun, you cannot make it properly. For you to stand 15 minutes reciting, you cannot make it. That time, if you use the time that you were strong, praying for Allah subhanahu, praying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will count. And that the time that you wake up, 3 a.m., you used to wake up and pray, that time, if you still feel, I cannot even pray, and you sit down, you will be rewarded like somebody who stand 15 minutes praying. So we don't have to waste our time. The time is so, it's so valuable. It's so important for us. It's expensive. The numbers, they say time is money. But brother, your time is actions. It's worship. Your time is your iman, your aqidah. May Allah make us understand. So the hadith, I will just complete the hadith reading. He said, "Innama hiya a'malukum wa sihharakum." He said, it is all about your action, okay? And then I will recompense you with it. Whoever finds good should give thanks and praise to Allah. That's what I'm saying. The moment you find yourself in goodness, the day of Qiyamah, even the people, we already know that they will say, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, الذي هدانا لهذا. وقل الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ ولدا. You will see it and you will see. وقالوا الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعدا. This is how they will say. The people, when they make it to Jannah, they know that they don't deserve, their action doesn't deserve to make it to Jannah, brothers. The action that we're doing, don't think that what we're doing is worthy in the sight or comparing to the Jannah of Allah, brothers. And I gave you the example, is an Israeliyat, but it's they take it to make people realize it. A man worship, he cut off himself from what? He break himself from what? Dunya. He went to the jungle and stayed. He only worship Allah. He doesn't do anything bad. He doesn't curse. He doesn't bite that. But it's only him and Allah and the nature. He just worship Allah there. And yes, he has been worship Allah, then he passed away. They say the day of Qiyamah, the moment they take him to Jannah, the Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the angels, take my servant, okay, out of my mercy and give him to Jannah. He was like, no, Ya Allah, how out of your mercy? It's not through my action? He said, no, it's my mercy. It's out through my mercy you're going to make it to Jannah. He said, no, me, I cut up everything and then I was worshipping you all the time. It's my action. They said it's the only one part of the eye they just took and put on the scales. And the way his all action he had done, it not even reach the half of what? The eye. And the Allah, command ordered the angels to throw him in the half. Sometimes we think we are something. The moment you do the action, you forget about it. Try to act like you don't know anything, you don't do anything. Try to, you know, act like you don't know anything. If they call people to for something, just run, go. Some people, they think, oh, they are, you know, they have the key of getting over here. Or some people like that. Yeah. They always do that. SubhanAllah. Huh? Look at him. Look. No. SubhanAllah. You have to find yourself, you know, always focusing on yourself. If you want to advise a person, advise them. But don't make it look like you're already dead. No one. The people that Allah already, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam even told them they are jinnah, they start crying. They cry. So the one who even will, you know, they promise him he's the one who has the key of the jinnah, he's the one who will go and knock and they will open. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he never just, you know, always, you know, tell people you will fire. So no, except from the revelation. We understand? Except from revelation. He doesn't curse, he doesn't humiliate, and no. May Allah make us understand. And whoever finds other than that, let him blame no one but himself. We have to understand that Aqidat Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, if a person makes it to Jannah, is out of mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a person makes it to hellfire, it is because of the justice, because Allah is just, the reason why he made it to what? To hellfire. May Allah protect us from that one. Because his actions are the one, he's the one that he had to blame himself. Even Shaitan will tell you, brothers, what is so sad is that Shaitan will have, there's one ayah that the Mufassirin, they call Khutbah al-Shaitan. Khutbah al-Shaitan, the speech of Shaitan, the door of Qiyam. Because when everything is done, the hellfire people and so on, people start blaming, you know, blame here, blame even Shaitan. Shaitan will tell them, no, Allah call you, okay, Allah call you on himself, and I just promise you something also, and then you follow me. So, فَلَا تَلُومُونِي. Do not blame me, but وَلُومُ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Blame yourself. It's like in Surah Al-Hashr, who remember that ayah. فمثل الشيطان إذ قال للإنسان اكفر فلما كفر قال إني بريء منك إني أخاف الله كلمة جدا رب العالمين بعد الله سيما كان عاقبتهما أنهما في النار خالدين فيها. Well, we have to always realize that Allah is just ولا يظلم ربك أحدا. Allah doesn't do the injustice. He is always just. It doesn't take your right and give to someone. No. That's the reason why he said at the beginning, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said what he related from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah himself made injustice haram upon himself. And at the beginning I asked you guys if Allah can do injustice. If you guys remember, I asked that question. If Allah can do justice, can be unjust. And a lot of people will respond, no. But some scholars, some scholars have that debate also. And they say that if you say Allah cannot, it is like he is not capable of doing it. And we know that Allah is capable of doing everything. Okay? But he chose not to be like that. We understand? He can, because, no one will ask him question him about what he's doing. But we are the one Allah will ask. When you do something, a person if you can ask you what, why. But when Allah did something, you cannot ask the question. So he had the power to do injustice, but he refused to do it. The reason why I ask a leader, ask a person in a very highest position, and you're the one who's in lowest position, did something, you know that you have everything to just punish him, to oppress him, and you choose not to do it. These are the people, Imam Al-Adl, the people, the day of Qiyamah, Allah will put on his shade, The day there's no shade, except Allah's shade. Because you have opportunity to do it and you don't do it. Alright? But for someone will warn you. You have the capability of paying him back because you have the power, you have everything, and you choose to forgive. SubhanAllah. وَلَمَنْ صَبَرُ وَغَفَرُ فَإِنَّ ذَلَكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. Because for you to forgive after someone, you can just punish right away, and he warn you and you just choose not to pay him back. Allah said, this is one of the very hardest things to do, and he is the one who will reward. He warn you. إِنَّمَا يُوَفِّ الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Allah will reward the people of who hold on sabr, okay? Without accountability. He will reward them with Jannah. Alright? Without accountability. So here the Sheikh is explaining to us what we learned, we read last time. We reached that page or that area where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam related from his Lord. He said, ثُمَّ أُوَفِيكُ الْإِيَّاهَ ثُمَّ أُوَفِيكُ الْإِيَّاهَ. يا عبادي لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم. This is where we were. Alright? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, according to the explanation of Sheikh here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يا عبادي لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم قاموا على صعيد واحد واحد يعني في مكان واحد. فإذا اجتمع الخلق كلهم جنهم وإنسهم أولهم وآخرهم كل واحد سأل الله وحاجته. If all of you, the jinn kind and the mankind, the one who was created, the first one who was created among the human being, and the last one who will live on this earth, and also among the jinns, they come together in a place, and they are asking Allah everything. Honestly, they are asking. You are asking Allah maybe a good wife. You are asking Allah a lot of work. You are asking Allah something. He is asking. She is asking. All of us, the jinn people, they are asking. They ask them. And Allah give all of us what we have asked. Alright? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it is not going to decrease what he has. Except, okay, the scenario of when you put a needle in the sea, okay, and you take it out. That small drop of water that has, is the same thing it reduces. It doesn't even reduce anything. If you put even your finger, even your water, your hand, you put and you take something from the sea, did you see something decrease from the sea? Nothing. So Allah has, it's limitless. It's limitless, bounty that Allah has. So we should always ask Allah for us. Before you go and ask Sheikh Ibrahim, pray at night and ask Allah first. Before you go to him. If he gave you, it is Allah who gave you. Say Alhamdulillah first, then he say, Jazakallah khair Sheikh Ibrahim. Sometimes we don't have that. You see a person, they give you, if I give you $5, and say, oh, Jazakallah brother, thank you so much. It's good to make dua like that. And you see the brother also who give it, no. It's good when, to show, to be grateful when someone do that. If you don't have tongue, that also thank a human being. It is hard for you to have the tongue that can what? Praise and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ لَا يَشْكُرُ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرُ اللَّهُ. So you have to praise Allah for this. And ask him, he has limitless treasure. He doesn't need it. It's for you. Just ask him. Don't think it's finished. It is there. Today, sometimes we don't have that belief. That's the reason why if Allah gives someone, Allah raise one of our ancestors, We feel jealous. And we think it's like, look like it is your reason that Allah take and give to someone. Sometimes that's what it means. When you see a person, brothers, when we are together like that, you know, we are all together like that, and you hear that someone just have a very beautiful house, he bought it by himself, and so on. You will see a person, some people got mad. They got mad like that person went and emptied their account to buy that house. No, it's Allah who gave him. It is Allah who gave him, brother. Yours is there. It's coming, baby. Why should you be you know angry? Why can't you be happy with your brother or your sister? Wallahi, if we have that, you know, if we really correct our iman, our belief, there's not going to be envy among the Muslim. You can have a dhikta, which is a kind of you are jealous of him in a good way. You want to be like him. Okay, you want to be like him, but not praying that he lost what he has, or not, you know, being unhappy of what he has, but you are happy for him having that. You are happy for having a person you know who is among the Muslim who has that blessings of Allah, but you also, if Allah blessed you with that person, inshallah, alhamdulillah, I pray, may Allah give me the same thing, and Allah give me capability of doing better than what he's doing. It's good. But you see, brother, you know, some brother, they Allah bless them with something. Another brother see it, they act like, he's not the first one to have it. And what? Oh, I used to have an uncle who also was working in that. What's his problem? Why are you gonna just praise God? MashaAllah, alhamdulillah. May Allah bless you with that. The brother will just come and tell you about that. The thing that they said, but you have to be careful. Please, praise him, like congratulate him, make prayer for him first. He is not, you know, hoping that kind of hatred from you. Oh, God, I'm going to Umrah. So, brothers, we have to be careful, subhanAllah. We have to be careful, the bounty of Allah, it is enough, it is immense. It cannot finish. It will never finish, brothers. Whatever he gave to Sheikh Fawzi, he will give you. Whatever he gave to Sheikh Ibrahim, he will give me also. And brothers, if among us, we are all poor, and Allah raised Sheikh Idris, and he has money, alhamdulillah, among us, at least we have the light. If I have a headache, inshallah, Allah put us among you, put you among us so that, you know, you have to buy me a Tylenol. I don't have money for that. Right? It's a benefit. I take benefit from it. But some people, the majority of the thing we have, that jealousy and envy, make us, when a person is trying to go, we try to destroy them. We pull them down instead of pushing them so that they become higher. And it's also the problem also is that the bonus that Allah also give, they have their own problem also, they become out. Sometimes that's the problem also. The moment Allah gives a person something, but as a Muslim, it's not because that person become arrogant, you become envious. So it's double crime for both sides. If one is negative, you keep your positivity. It's not gonna harm you. For me, Allah make us understand this. So we spoke already about, you know, jinn and stuff last week. I think we explained that the jinn. You know, the jinn problem is like, it's not our problem. Okay, we have to stay away from jinn stuff. Okay, but the hadith is not about the jinn. It's because Sheikh brought the explanation of jinn. They are unseen world, and it's only Allah who knows their numbers. And they are like, among them you see the mu'min, you see the believer, you see also the munafiq, the kafir. The same way you see they are, you know, criminals among them. Just like among the human being. We understand. Shh. appeal. So here فأعطيت كل إنسان مسألته ما نفذت مما عندي لأن يمين الله ملأ لا يغيضها نفقة سحاء. You know, the Sheikh is saying, according to one hadith, وَلِلَّهِ خَزَائِنُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ also. That's what I explained. Allah, when you look at the, you know, Allah's hand is full of bounties. He's not going to perish. He's not going to finish. Just keep asking, even if he give everybody what you need, okay? But what is going to happen? It's not going to happen. He just tell us like that. We all know that وَلَوْ بَسَطَ اللَّهُ الرِّزْقَ لِعِبَادِهِ لَبَغَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Brothers, if Allah was about to give us what we want, everybody want, when you just grow up, you become a human adult, you just want your account to be full of billions of dollars. Oh, you got a very good house. At the same time, you just marry the most beautiful, you know, woman in your eye. The same day she's pregnant, the same day she delivered 4 babies. Everybody want that. Right? But it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. وَلَوْ بَسَطَ اللَّهُ رِزْقَ لِعِبَادِهِ لَبَغَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Imagine we are all have money. We have everything we want. Who's going to be a carpenter? Who's going to be a tailor? Who's going to be a cleaner? Who's going to cook? Where's the restaurant? Huh? And who's going to be a doctor? Because if you want, everyone to talk, do you want to go to the hospital? No one wants to go to the hospital. If you ask Allah, Allah, I just want to be a doctor. When I'm sick, you help me just, you know, I put myself, give myself a lot of things and then you give me cure. He does that, there's not going to be hospital. But Allah is making that so that, okay, no one, we depend on one another. This is how we have to depend on one another. The moment you have what you want, you become yourself Allah. You yourself, you want this, you have it. You want this, you have it. You just want to right now, Shebra, you just want to right now, you know, I want to just be in Medina right now. And blink of eye, you are in Medina. The same day you just pray, you might say, let me just go to Abidjan. The same, no. So you become Allah yourself, you become God, and it's not going to work. When he's going to rain, he said, Allah, don't make it rain. Shebra said, what are you talking about? I want the rain to make it, you know, I want the rain today. Shefoy said, what are you talking about rain? I want snow. So it's going to be a problem. We have to understand that Allah knows what is best for us. Allah. May Allah make us understand. And may Allah guide our heart. So here, فَلَا تَنْقُسَ خَزَائِنُ اللَّهِ بِالْإِنْفَاقِ. Allah, you know, the khazain, the treasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never be decreased because of his giving. So the reason why I'm saying that is not right for you to see a blessing of Allah upon your brother and you got mad. And you are not happy of it. Like they took yours and give to him. Alright? Don't be happy and ask at the same time. Moment is a test for him, is a test for you. At the same time you ask Allah, Ya Allah, the way you grant him this blessing, bless him with it, and also, Ya Allah, bless me with it. The moment you make that dua, Ya Allah, bless him with that blessing, bless him more, the angels are making dua for you. But you make that face of mean face, the envy and negativity, it's not right. It's not for Muslim. This is a bad character. May Allah protect us from that. Allah is saying, Ya ibadi innama hiya amalukum nusiha lakum thumma wafiqum iyaha. That's what I said. Laysa lakum illa amalukum. You don't have anything, brothers. Nothing is matter in this life except your actions. It's your action. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. It's about your action, brother. The moment you wake up from morning to night, ask yourself, what the time you spend, have you spent that time for your action, or the action for you, or the action against you? Because we have to understand that. Sometimes the action against us and the action for us, for our favor. So we have to think about it. And especially, that's the topic that the Sheikh even brought today. It's so important that we don't demolish our own actions. we don't destroy our own action by backbiting, by insulting, by saying stuff that doesn't have any, you know, any importance in your life. It doesn't give you anything except what? Harm. Because the harm is like you build a house and then someone will come and take it because you already cheat them. You cheat them, you insult them, or you backbite them. Gossip. Mira potetas. فهذا دليل على أن الجزاء إنما يكون على عمل على العمل.
What do you call it?
And the Sheikh Allah is saying that the Sheikh brought, he said, فليس هناك مجال تنال به رحمة الله إلا العمل الذي تعمله ولا تعذب إلا على عمله. That's what I said. A person will never have Jannah except through their action. And a person will never make it to hellfire except what? Their action. ولا تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون. That's what the Sheikh said. And ولا تجزون, you are not going to be rewarded except for what you have done. فعليك أن تهتم بعملك لأنه مناة سعادتك وشقاوتك. This is the source of your what? Of your happiness and your what? Your miserable life in this dunya and the hereafter. The action are the meaning of your success or your what? Your loss. Yalla potatoes. وهذا من فضل سبحانه وتعالى أن يوصل الأعمال is from the mercy and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the favor of Allah for you, okay, that the angels are recording your action. Is the among the favor of Allah, because you will see it and you say, oh, you're not gonna just go and they tell you, oh, what you have done, you had done wrong only, and a person go to hellfire. No, they will show the person what you have done until the person even testify. ما لهذا الكتاب لا يقادر صغيرة ولا كبيرة إلا أحصاها. From where come this kind of book? The minus, you know, the minus things I have done is there. Subhanallah, I seek refuge from this kind of book. But a person also himself know that I have done that. I don't deserve anything except hellfire. May Allah protect us from that. So at the end, the Sheikh. فهذا حديث عظيم وجليل القادر كان السلف يعظمون ويخافون منه إذا قرأوه قرأوه. This hadith is so important that it's important that even the people before us, the imams, the Salaf al-Saleh, they said what? When they read it, they get scared because it's about the day of Qiyamah bonus. Okay? لا يحتاج إلى تعب في فهمي. This hadith is so simple. If you go through the word, you will understand it. Okay? وكان أبو إدريس الحولاني إذا قرأ هذا الحديث جثى على ركبتيه. There is one Imam called Abu Idris al-Hawlani. Imam. So when he read this hadith, he always, جثى على ركبتيه. He will like bend on his knees. He will just sit down on his knees like that. Like he's so scared, so that he's not sitting comfortable. So may Allah make us understand, inshallah. Inshallah, next week we will continue for the next hadith, the hadith number 25, inshallah. Or if there is something to add in this hadith, we'll bring it. Subhanakallah wa bihamdika, inshallah, la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.